Good morning. Our greeting to all of our parishioners and to all those who may be visiting is taken from our mission statement. Our Eucharistic community at Holy Cross welcomes all to faith in Jesus Christ. Our challenge is not to get discouraged, but to hand ourselves over to the nourishment of the Word and sacrament that God offers, a nourishment that carries us on our life's journey to eternal life. All we need is to have belief. Today's readings may be found in the Red Worship Hymnal, number 1164. As we get ready for our Eucharistic celebration, we ask that you silence all cell phones and take a quiet moment or two to prepare our hearts to hear God's word and to participate in the offering of the Mass. The celebrant of this Mass is Father Wheeland. Please join in the entrance hymn, hymn number 610, Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven.
Good morning. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate this most sacred mystery, let us call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you came into the world to save us. Lord, have mercy. To the glory that is ours Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and these and earth. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God. Let us pray. Open the book. O God, who had prepared for those you love good things which no eye can see, fill our hearts, we pray, with the warmth of your love, so that in loving you in all things and above all things, we may attain your promises, which surpass every human desire. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. I'm sorry. We have the Liturgy of the Word for children. We invite the kindergarten through fifth graders. Thank you, Charlie.
A reading from the first book of Kings. Elijah went a day's journey into the desert until he came to a broom tree and sat beneath it. He prayed for death, saying, "This is enough, O Lord. Take my life, for I am no better than my father's." He lay down and fell asleep under the broom tree, but then an angel touched him and ordered him to get up and eat. Elijah looked, and there at his head was a hearth cake and a jug of water. After he ate and drank, he lay down again, but the angel of the Lord came back a second time, touched him and ordered, "Get up and eat, else the journey will be too long for you. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extol his name. I sought the Lord, and he answered me and delivered me from all my fears.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
Look to him that you may be radiant with joy, and your faces may not blush with shame. When the afflicted man called out, the Lord heard, and from all his distress he saved him.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. Taste and see how good the Lord is. Blessed the man who takes refuge in him.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, Do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, with which you were sealed for the day of redemption. All bitterness, fury, anger, shouting, and reviling must be removed from you, along with all malice. And be kind to one another, compassionate, forgiving one another as God has forgiven you in Christ. So be imitators of God as beloved children and live in love as Christ loved us and handed himself over for us as a sacrificial offering to God for a fragrant aroma. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. The Jews murmured about Jesus because he said, "I am the bread that came down from heaven." And they said, "Is this not Jesus, the son of Joseph? Do we not know his father and mother? Then how can he say, 'I have come down from heaven'?" Jesus answered and said to them, "Stop murmuring among yourselves. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up on the last day. It is written in the prophets, 'They shall all be taught by God.' Everyone who listens to my Father and learns from him comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father, except the one who is from God, he has seen the Father. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate that manna in the desert, but they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world." The Gospel of the Lord. Familiarity sometimes breeds contempt. The Jews of Jesus' day thought they knew who he was, because they knew his mother, his brothers, his sisters. They knew where he came from. So how could he say that he had come down from heaven? And that familiarity closed off their mind and their heart to the power of God, who could send his son into the world, who could make that son give his life on the cross for us. And I think many times our surroundings, our modern day society, cuts us off from the wisdom and the love of God, cuts us off from understanding what God has done for us. And one of the things I will cite is the whole idea of food in our modern life. Food has become something we use only to feed ourselves. We have lost the concept of community. We have lost the concept of sharing. Do you know how many restaurants there are, fast food chains there are, places where you can get subs in this area in 5 miles of Holy Cross Church to count them something. I've eaten at all of them, so I know. But that whole idea is that food does not have that meaning of substance and of community anymore. Even our own homes, many times the food is not told, that dinner is ready not by the bell on the oven, but by the doorbell when the pizza person comes and delivers supper for us, which we promptly eat in front of the TV set with TV tables, watching the TV. The whole idea of a meal being together, a meal being more than just food but nourishment, has been lost in our society. Even go out to one of the nicer restaurants, and many times you'll see two people sitting there, both talking on cell phones. I don't think to each other, I imagine to other people, but they have lost that relationship with each other. Or you go to what they call a sports bar, a sports restaurant, and you'll see 25, 30 TV sets that can preoccupy you so you don't realize how much you're feeding yourself. You don't realize what you're doing, and you're completely watching the TV. And I think that's one of the modern, they just feed themselves. And it's not a concern about other people, it's only themselves. I think when the priest was here from India a couple weeks ago, he talked about the poverty is there and how much they appreciate a meal, even though it might only be rice, how they share that with others, always giving more, some of their blessings to other people so that they can build community. And that's what Mass should be, us coming here and building community, serving one another, being mindful of the fact that we are nourished by the Lord. We are nourished to journey in this world. The prophet in the first reading of today's Mass, when he was given substance from the Lord, was able to stand up and go on a 40-day journey to a holy place because he had been nourished by the Lord. And if we are nourished spiritually in the Eucharist, then we can do great things far beyond our own imagining, far beyond what we can do just on our own, because the Lord informs what we do and he brings great blessing to what we do. And so I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. And that is what Jesus did. The night before he suffered and died, he gave his body and blood to his disciples so that they might be strengthened for what was going to happen the next 3 days. That they would be strengthened even though they saw their leader, their master, sacrificing his life on the cross. They would come to know that that was not a sign of defeat, but a sign of new life, a sign of greatness, for he would rise 3 days later to be able to lead them and to guide them and to show them where we're all destined for the everlasting kingdom of heaven and for this world. But it is a pledge of what we will receive when we end our existence on this world, when we come to what Scripture describes as the lasting banquet of heaven. That idea that we will be filled with the plenitude of God's love. For he gave his flesh for the life of the world, and he gives us the Eucharist for our strengthening, so that we can do great things in his name, so that we can proclaim his kingdom here on earth and come to that fullness of his kingdom in heaven. I am the bread of life. I have come down upon this earth to nourish you, to strengthen you, and to give you a pledge of everlasting joy and happiness. This is the meal that we should seek. This is the spiritual strengthening that we need. And we do it in a community of believers, a community who proclaim their belief in Jesus and their belief in the principles which he gives us. The second reading of today's Mass tells us how we should act if we are Eucharistic people, that should we not be quarreling or fighting with one another, but that we should be trying to bring peace and love to one another. And that is the spirit of our community, that is the strength that we have from the Eucharist, and that is what will bring us to everlasting life if we obey the commandments and seek to bring love and peace into the world. Let us stand and let us profess that faith of our community. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. Therefore, I am the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. Let us pray that all of us may seek the nourishment that comes from the bread of life, that we may receive the Eucharist to guide us, to strengthen us, to walk on this earth and to do the will of God and to bring his kingdom upon this earth. Give us strength and hear the petitions that we now offer.
Pray for the church, that we may continually be nourished by the word of God and grow in our faith and relationship with Christ. In safety, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that in response for God's many gifts, we pray for the protection of our men and women serving in sick and suffering, that God may give them courage and strength. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that the faithful who have died may dwell forever in the house of God, especially Anne-Marie Shute, Lester Steveley, the father of Kenneth Steveley, Joan Fletcher, the mother of Deidre Steveley, and for Charles Ross, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pause for a moment and make our own private petitions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, we are part of your community. We work to bring that community to the world, bringing down the kingdom of God upon us. By doing that, being faithful to the Eucharist, we hope to be nourished so that we will enter into the fullness of your love in the holy banquet of heaven. Strengthen us always. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our second collection today is the ministry collection. Please join in the offertory hymn, hymn number 923, I Receive the Living God.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of our mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him the hosts of angels adore your majesty and rejoice in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one choir of exultation praise. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Salvatore, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with her spouse, Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer one another a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Are there any ministers of communion who are taking communion to the shut-ins? Let us pray. Through these sacraments, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that conformed to his image on earth, we may merit also to be his co-heirs in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Now, when you go out, wait till I catch you. Come out.
Next Sunday, there will be a used uniform sale in the gym and a chance to pick up your back-to-school packet from 11 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. Next Saturday, August 15th, is a holy day, but not a holy day of obligation since it falls on a Saturday. Mass at 8 a.m. will be for the Assumption. Team Impact Uganda continues this week on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday for grades 7, 8, and 9, and you can register 30 minutes prior to the start of camp. There will be a coffee hour after Mass today in the Parish Center. And please join the recessional hymn number 585, I Want to Walk as a Child of the Light. And please see our bulletin or website at holycrossrochester.org for these and all parish details.
I want to thank Bill Brown for his beautiful solo during communion. Thank you, Bill. Just a warning. I'm going to be using my scooter coming out, and anybody leaving Mass early, I get 10 points for everyone I nail. So. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks.